Oxenholme Station, or Oxenholme Lake District as it's known, is the gateway to the lakes. It is from here that trains travel the 10.25 miles along the branch line to Windermere. The Oxenholme to Windermere branch line is the first and only surviving railway to serve the heart of the Lake District and was built in the teeth of strong opposition from campaigners led by the poet William Wordsworth. Today, Oxenholme is the only village on the West Coast main line with its own railway station. There are three platforms. Platform 1 for the up line to London, Platform 2 for the down line to Glasgow, and Platform 3, the down line to Windermere. It's managed by Avanti West Coast and has a ticket office and ticket machine, as well as coffee shops serving each of the platforms. The station at Oxenholme was opened in 1846, when both the first 20-mile stage of the Lancaster and Carlisle Railway and the first 2-mile stage of the Kendal and Windermere Railway were opened. The original station building was designed by the architect William Tite, who was better known for building the Royal Exchange in London in 1840. In fact, the station was originally known as Kendal Junction, but the more familiar Oxenholme station came into use around 1860. And the station was extensively altered in 1881 when the level crossing was replaced by the pedestrian subway and road bridge. The station name had the suffix Lake District added in 1988. The station is located in beautiful surroundings, particularly on a day like this, and there are superb views across to the town of Kendal. Looking to the future, passengers will be able to catch HS2 trains from Oxenholme in order to access the high-speed network further to the south. HS2 will allow travel between Oxenholme and the new station at Birmingham Curson Street in just 1 hour and 20 minutes, which is around 45 minutes quicker than today's fastest time. The station's popularity with visitors to the lakes was fictionalised by Arthur Ransome in the Swallows and Amazons series of children's books, where it was renamed Strickland Junction. Walking along the platform here at Oxenholme, my mind went back to a terrible rail crash which happened just outside the station in February 2007 when a Virgin Class 390 Pendolino derailed, leaving one person dead and 22 others injured. A number of Avanti West Coast services call at this station to provide connections with the Windermere branch, as well as enabling customers to travel on to London or up to Glasgow or Edinburgh. Meanwhile, all TransPennine Express services call at this station for connections to Manchester Airport, as well as Glasgow and Edinburgh. Northern Rail operates services to and from Windermere, with some occasionally running through to Lancaster, Preston, Manchester Airport and Liverpool Lime Street. There were no direct trains running into and out of London Euston on the date of my visit to Oxenholme, with trains arriving and departing from Milton Keynes Central, which was due to track upgrade work taking place at Watford Junction. Well, it's been a really good day at Oxenholme. It's been my first visit to the station, and it's been good to see such a variety of trains and also lots of passengers out for the Good Friday getaway. Some of the highlights for me were seeing a rail grinder, and I've not seen one of those before, and also the log train with its beautiful smell of cut wood as it passed through the station. It's been a glorious day, the warmest of the year so far, and even the trains needed to cool down.